It's Saturday night. I've just recovered from COVID and now I'm going to see Liam Gallagher at the Royal Albert Hall. Life is crazy. Let's go.
Update. The tube terminated at Sloane Square. I don't know why. So, just walking along the King's Road now. It's going to be a bit of a mission to get to Royal Albert Hall. But let's do it.
Thank you.
I am home and completely exhausted. But what an incredible gig. I have to say, I gotta say this first. This gig was a little bit marred by the transport issues I had, the fact that I had to walk from Sloane Square to the Royal Albert Hall because South Ken was shut. And that's my own fault for not checking. It was engineering work, so I could have checked and made other plans. But it meant I had an extra half hour walk there and back again, even, you know, on top of the tube journey. And, you know, I think I'm so much better from COVID, but still quite short of breath and fatigued, and I really, really felt it. I really felt it. And I'm gonna be comatose tomorrow, I think. But seeing Liam at the Royal Albert Hall, that is just something that I would never have imagined possible. Like, even seeing him at the O2 last year was incredible. And, you know, and getting down the front, that was such an incredible privilege and rare treat, you know. And even though I wasn't at the front tonight because I had a seat sort of at the back of the stalls, I was still quite close. And what that gave me tonight was a view of the whole crowd just going mental. And that was beautiful. There were just some moments where I, because I was quite knackered by about halfway through Liam's set, I was feeling it. I was stood up, but I just sort of leaned back on the chair and just took it all in. And it was such an overwhelming, incredible experience. And again, like at the O2, Stand By Me was a total highlight. There's just something about that song that is just such a beautiful anthem. I mean, there is the Oasis back catalogue, I do have to say. You know, there are other bands from the 90s that I love more, but I can't think of a better word to describe Oasis's songs than they're just magical. They just encapsulate that era so perfectly, in a way that other bands cannot, because none were as huge and ubiquitous as Oasis. So love them or hate them, they epitomize. Is that a word? They are the 90s. And lucky for me, because I love them. Stand By Me, like I said, was amazing. And Once was the other song that I remembered being so incredible at the O2, and it was again tonight. But then there were some other songs that he didn't play at the O2. I'm still, like, I'm quite new in my Liam Gallagher gigging life. I saw Oasis once, and now this is my second Liam gig. So I'm still sort of collecting songs that I've heard for the first time. And Slide Away was incredible. I feel like I've used that word 20 times now. Incredible. It was incredible. Slide Away was just so beautiful. And the best of the Oasis songs for me, I think, was Cast No Shadow, which, again, he didn't do that at the O2. And that's a song that, when I first heard it in 95, I was going through some stuff, and Cast No Shadow really just encapsulated how I was feeling at the time. And hearing it again tonight, because I'm also going through some stuff, there's a lot happening in my life at the minute. Some of it great, and some of it not so great. And so, like, Cast No Shadow really just hit a chord tonight, and I cried a bit. And but then the new, you like Liam's solo stuff, we got Everything's Electric, the new single, which is, oh, it's my favorite single of the year, absolutely, so far. I mean, we're only March, but I adore that song. It just fills me with so much fire and energy whenever I listen to it. I had a job interview a few weeks ago, and I was listening to that song. I listened to it a few times in a row in the morning before I went to the interview. And I just carried that spirit with me into the interview. And what do you know? I got the job, which is another kind of stressful thing, because it's not started yet, but it's going to be a big change in my life. A brilliant one, but like, it's just going to make things very different for me this year. But I can't wait. And I thank Liam for me getting that job, because I think I was taking his spirit with me into the job interview. We also got a new song, Come On You Know, the title track to the upcoming album, and that sounded great. These dirty, sort of fuzzy guitars, which is not something I've heard from Liam before. I absolutely loved it, and I can't wait to hear that again when the album comes out. But yeah, overall, he wasn't in as, like, incredible spirits as he seemed to be in at the O2. He was fine and performing brilliantly, but I feel like the O2 show just had this atmosphere of sheer joy and celebration. There were so many emotions at that gig because of it being a free gig for the NHS, but also, you know, it was still very early on in gigs being allowed again, and for a lot of us, it was only my second proper gig back. Many people would have been their first. And, you know, that was just a really incredible emotional time to be going back to live music. And, you know, I don't think you'll ever be able to quite encapsulate that atmosphere again, which is fine, you know, onwards and upwards. And I'm just, you know, lucky that I was there. And, you know, so lucky to be there tonight as well, to see Liam at a venue like the Royal Albert Hall. Again, it's the sort of thing I never would have thought possible, and it's just a privilege. And yeah, I absolutely had an incredible time. It was, you know, fantastic to be back on my gigging feet again after COVID really giving me a kicking. If you've had COVID, you'll know. I mean, I know people have it to different severities. I had it like a bad flu, but it was bad. But yeah, to be back out and about again was wonderful. I just could have really done without all the walking. And also with, you know, life going a bit mental at the moment, as well as getting COVID, it was just so nice to get back to what I love most in the world, which is live music, and especially seeing someone like Liam. There's no one else like Liam. Like, he is the last rock and roll superstar, and we must treasure him and go and see him live all the time. Anyway, I need to collapse in a heap and try and sleep, but thank you for watching this little vlog. I hope you enjoyed it, and I don't know when I'm next gonna put a video up. Like I said, life's a bit crazy, and I'm just trying to get through stuff. So, hopefully, before too long, I'll be talking to you again in another video. Take care, and bye-bye.